Morning friends. In the previous session, we already discussed different types of flat wheel drives. The continuation of this is the determination of velocity ratio in the wheel drive. Right. So velocity ratio in bell drive. So as we already discussed, the power is transmitted from driving member to driven member. So let us take D1 is the diameter of driver pulley, diameter of dia of driver in the sense driver pulley, and D2 is diameter of driven pulley, or it is also known as follower driver pulley. Right. So N1 is the speed of the driver in terms of RPM. Speed of driver and N2 is the speed of follower. Speed of driven member. Okay. So these speed values are represented in terms of RPM, right? So now length of the belt that passes over the driver in 1 minute time. So what is N1 here? Revolutions per minute time. Revolutions per minute. How many revolutions the pulley will complete in a stipulated time of 1 minute time. So length of the belt that passes over the pulley. So length of the belt passes over the driver is equal to, so how do you calculate this? Revolutions per minute. N1 is number of revolutions per minute, and each revolution the driver is able to complete its circumferential distance. So what is the circumference of the driver? Pi d1 n1 is the circumference, n1 is the RPM, so that I will get total length of the belt that passes over the driver. Right. So similarly, the length of the belt that passes over the follower. Right. Similarly, length of the belt that passes over the follower or the driven member. Over the driven member. Driven pulley is equal to pi d2 n2. So but whatever the length of the belt is crossing the driver, it is equal to length of the belt that crossing over the driven pulley. So therefore these two values must be equal. Therefore pi d1 n1 is equal to pi d2 n2. So from this, pi gets cancelled. Therefore speed of the driven member
n2 divided by speed of the driver number n1 is equal to n2 by n1 is equal to d1 by d2. D1 by d2. So this is the velocity ratio or the speed ratio calculated for the given belt drive. Right? So speed of the follower divided by speed of the driven member. So follower or the driven member is the output member, and driver member is the input member. So output divided by input speed is equal to velocity ratio, that represented in terms of the diameters d1 and d2. So that means the speed is inversely proportional to the diameter of the pulley. Okay, so the thickness of the belt is neglected here. If you consider the thickness of the belt also into the consideration, then thickness of belt is also taken into consideration. Consideration. Then n2 by n1 is equal to d1 plus t divided by d2 plus t. Okay, so this is the velocity ratio of a belt drive when you consider thickness of the belt also into the consideration. Okay, so suppose if it is a compound belt drive which consists of two combinations of drivers and driven members, then the velocity ratio can also be expressed in a similar fashion. So in the case of compound belt drive, for compound belt drive, n2 by r by n4 by n1 is equal to then d1 by d2 into d3 by d4. Okay, so product of diameters of drivers, d1 and d2 are the drivers and d2 and d4 are the driven members, right? So since compound belt drive, let us take a compound belt drive. So this is, let us take, this is the driver and this is a driven pulley, right? And another pulley is mounted on this shaft. So this is, and another pulley is here. So let us take, this is and this is the pulley number 1, pulley 2, pulley 3 and pulley 4. So now here we have two belt drives. So one is between 1 and 2. This is one belt drive and this is another belt drive. Okay. So the velocity ratio between these two pulleys is equal to n1 by n2. N2 by n1 is equal to n2 by n1 equal to d1 by d2. Okay, similarly here n4 divided by n3 is equal to d3 divided by d4. So here this is a driver, so this is also a driver, and these two are the followers. So that means these two are the driven members. So now if you take the velocity ratio of this N2 by N1 into N4 by N3, but N2 and N3 are same because both the pulleys are mounted on the same shaft. So N2 and N3 gets cancelled, you will get N4 by N1, then D1 by D2 into D3 by D4. That's how you can find out the velocity ratio of compound belt drive consists of four pulleys. Okay. So this is the velocity ratio in belt drive. Right. So next one is slip of the belt. So as you know, the frictional grip between belt and the pulley is able to transmit power from one end to another end. If the frictional grip is not sufficient, or if the friction between the belt and the pulley is not effective, then there is no 100% power transmission. In such cases, there is a chance of forward motion of the driver without carrying the belt with it. So, the forward motion of the driver without carrying the belt with it is called slip of the belt. What do you mean by slip of the belt? The forward motion of the driver or the forward motion of the driving pulley without carrying the belt with it is called slip of the belt. Right? And is generally expressed in terms of percentages. Slip of the belt is generally expressed in terms of percentages. So as a result of the belt slipping, the velocity ratio is reduced. Okay, so hence the slipping of the belt is most common in belt drives. So that's why the belt drive should never be used where a definite velocity ratio is required. And the positive drive requirements, generally it is not possible with the flat belt drives because of this slippage, right? Let us take, S1 is the percentage of, S1 is the percentage of slip between driver and belt. Okay, so S1 is the percentage of slip. Between driver and belt. Okay, similarly, S2 is the percentage of slip between the driven member and the belt, or driven pulley and belt. Okay, so therefore, just like our previous analysis, velocity ratio calculation, the belt drive. So now also we will consider similar analysis here. So the velocity of the belt passing over the, therefore, velocity of the belt. Passing over the driver. Right? So, velocity of the belt passing over the driver per second is equal to, so what is the velocity of the belt? So, pi dN1 by 60. Okay, so earlier per minute it is pi dN1, now it is per second, it is pi dN1. N1 by 60. Okay, but due to the effect of slip of S1 percentage on this driver, this velocity is slightly reduced, and this reduced velocity you must subtract from the actual velocity pi dN1 by 60. So reduced component of this velocity is 5 d1 n1 divided by 60 into s1 by 100, because s1 is the percentage, so s1 by 100. So you can simplify this, right? 5 d n1 by 60 is equal to 5 d1 n1 by 60 into 1 minus s1 by 100. So this is the velocity of the belt passing over the driver per second, which is having a slip of s1 percentage. Okay, so this is the final velocity of the belt that is passing over the driver. In a similar fashion, you can find out the velocity of the belt passing over the driven member or the follower per second. Similarly, velocity of the belt passing over driven member or follower per second. Right? So just replace N1 with N2 so that I will get what is equal to 5 d2 n2 by 60. 5 d2 n2 by 60. Okay. 5 d2 n2 by 60. Clear? So now it is equal to, what is the velocity of the belt reaching the driven member? This is the velocity of the belt that is crossing over the driver. And this is the velocity, input velocity of the belt that is reaching the follower. So this is equal to 5 d1 n1 by 60 into 1 minus s1 by 100. This is input velocity to the driven member, and from this input velocity some amount of component, velocity component, must be reduced because of the slippage in the driven pulley. That is, the component is 1 minus s2 by 100. Okay, now if you simplify this further, then you will get 5 d1 n1 by 60 into 1 minus s1 by 100 minus s2 by 100. S2 by 100. Okay, so you can simplify this as 5 d1 n1 by 60 into 1 minus of s1 plus s2 divided by 100. So now s1 plus s2 is the total slip. So the total slip you can express as total slip of the belt drive. 5 d1 n1 by 60 1 minus s by 100. Okay, so this is the output velocity of the driver, but in terms of output velocity of a driven member, and this is expressed as 5 d2 n2 by 60. Okay, so from this analysis, you can write N2 by N1 is equal to, N2 by N1 is equal to, 5 gets cancelled, 60 cancelled here, then N2 by N1 is equal to D1 by D2 to 1 minus S by 100.
Okay, so this is the velocity ratio of the belt with the slipper, right? Suppose if the slipper is zero, then S becomes zero, then this term becomes zero. 1 minus 0 is 0, so that n2 by n1 is equal to d1 by d2. So that's how we can calculate the velocity ratio when the slip is taken into the consideration. Okay, is it clear? So these are the two topics related to the velocity ratio calculation in the belt drives. Okay, I hope all of you understood this concept. Thank you.